The news continues now at 5:30. Good evening, everyone. I'm Yuki Washington.
And I'm Nicole Brewer, in for Jessica Dean. Health reporter Stephanie Stahl is here with this Einstein Healthcare Science Center report.
This is really an exciting development. You know, there have been a variety of technologies that help paralyzed people move again. But this is the first that, with implants and computer science, that is allowing a quadriplegic patient to use just his brain to move. Bill Koshevar is doing things he never thought he would do again, like grabbing this mug and taking a sip and eating mashed potatoes.
The light bulb went off and said, this really is possible, because before that, I thought, you know, I'd never move my arms again.
The 56-year-old was paralyzed below his shoulders 8 years ago in a bicycle accident. Now he's using experimental technology that allows him to move his hand and arm simply by thinking.
Yeah, I just did the calibration.
Electrodes are implanted in the brain that record signals of his intended movements. A computer interprets the information, and electrodes implanted in the arm are stimulated.
So he thinks about a movement. We record from the brain signals. We figure out what he was trying to do, and then we make his arm do that by stimulating it.
Researchers believe Bill is the first quadriplegic to have his arm and hand movements restored with this kind of technology.
These individuals are basically lack independence almost completely, are totally reliant on others for everything they do. And even giving them these simple functions is really meaningful to them.
Bill uses the system in the lab 3 times a week, but work is underway to use the technology in everyday life.
Then I can go anywhere and use my arm, so that would be spectacular.
Wow. Now, researchers at Cleveland Clinic, where the technology is being tested, say that could be possible in 2 to 3 years as the field of biomedical research is expanding quickly. And Bill's case where they did that with him was published today in the journal Lancet.
Wow.
Absolutely amazing.
It's incredible technology. Steph, thank you.